Well, the temps have cooled off a bit today, so we have got the perfect recipe for you in the kitchen this morning. We've brought back Chef Holly Vine, who has an adorable website that I absolutely love. It's called Holly Likes to Cook, and she does.
I do.
You're going to cook for us this morning in a slow cooker.
Yes.
Or a crock pot, whatever you want to call it. Yeah. I love cooking with that during
it's
the fall.
It's so easy, and I was saying earlier, I feel like I'm cheating a bit today because it's such a simple recipe. But especially when it's coming into fall and you're going out in the morning to work and it's dark and you're coming home in the evening and it's dark, mm-hmm. it's lovely to open the door to that smell of something fresh cooked where you don't actually have to do anything.
Yeah, and it's warm comfort foods around this time of year are great. So what are we making today?
So we're going to be making a slow cooker beef ragu. Mm-hmm. And what's excellent about this dish is it's once it's done in the slow cooker, it's great. You can have it over pasta or polenta, but you can also go in and make other dishes with it. So you could make it into a lasagna, add beans and spices, make it into a chili.
So this is almost a great base.
Absolutely. So you can make one big pot of it and it can do you all week without getting bored.
I love that. Okay, what are the ingredients then that we need?
So we've got a nice big piece of meat here. It's a bottom round roast, which is a little tougher, but in the slow cooker, not a problem, really mm-hmm. flavorful. There's some garlic, some red onion, red wine, and some crushed tomatoes, some spices, which we'll talk about later, and I'm going to serve it over some parmesan polenta as well, so we can actually have a nice little meal later.
And polenta is something really simple and easy to make.
Yes, it is. I think people find it quite intimidating because is it pasta, is it potato, no one knows. Yeah. But it's actually really simple, and especially when we're coming into colder weather, it's so comforting.
Okay, and again, something else that you can kind of make in bigger batches and
yep.
save it. Everyone can eat it morning to night. We're going to get things started in just a bit.
You're back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef Holly Vine is here. Holly likes to cook. We got slow cooker beef ragu mm-hmm. on the menu. A lot of people don't use the crock pots, use the slow cookers, and it's easy.
I know. It's one of those things that I think is kind of thought as being a bit old-fashioned,
right.
but they're actually even more applicable to our day-to-day, like busy lives nowadays, because
right.
you can pop it on in the morning at the same time as brewing up your first pot of coffee, and by the time you get home in the evening, dinner's done for you.
It's ready, and a lot of people are like, oh my God, I don't want to leave this thing plugged in all the time, all day long. It's fine.
Nowadays, they're so safe nowadays with yeah. the new ones. If you've got one from like the 60s, I might not use that one. But new ones are fine. You're absolutely fine.
Yes, if you have a slow cooker from the 60s, get rid of it. They're about 20,
school.
25 bucks. Get a new one. All right, what are we going to do right now?
Right, so what we've done is we've browned the beef, which mm-hmm. will just give it a little bit of extra flavor. But
okay.
if you really are in a pinch, you don't have to do this.
Okay.
It's just an extra bit of
and
flavor.
And it kind of seals everything in.
You
right.
get all these sort of like nice crusty bits.
And I like it like that.
Flavor.
I do, I like it like
and
that.
And then all we're going to do is build the slow cooker. So mm-hmm. I'm going to take the crock out just so that we've got a bit more space.
Got it.
If you want to pop the onions in there,
mm-hmm.
these are just sliced red onions.
Pour this in here.
And then we've got some garlic as well in that little pot. Just a bit of chopped up garlic.
Good.
I'm going to put this beastly bit of beef on top there.
Got it. I'll move this in closer to it.
Thank you very much.
Don't want to lose that.
And then on top of that, we're going to put our wine.
Okay.
And then our crushed tomatoes.
Got it.
And then we're just going to season that with some nice dried herbs. So I've got some oregano or some oregano, some basil or basil, and some parsley flakes.
I like basil.
I'm translating.
I do. I like basil. Okay, so I'm going to put this in here.
Yeah, just pop it all in there. It doesn't have to be like
so
delicate
gonna,
or anything.
We're going to pour all this in here. We're going to get this slow cooker
all in one go.
Know, cooking. And we'll see you around, 6 o'clock tonight?
Yeah, thank
you. All right, we'll wrap this up in just a little bit. Back to you. Vine joins us from Holly Likes to Cook. Slow roasted beef ragu is on the menu today, and man, it's a great day for this. Mm-hmm. It'll be a great weekend for this. You can make this, watch football this on Sunday. This
absolutely.
Is one of the good things.
Absolutely. And with a slow cooker as well, if you wanted to have it ready for like a big event, you can actually cook it overnight.
Oh, okay.
So
right.
when it's just done for you.
It's ready to go
up.
The next day.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Right. So by the magic of television, mm-hmm. this has been cooking for 10 hours.
Look at that.
10 hours.
10 hours.
No, 10 hours on low or
on
10?
On low.
Okay.
10 hours on low. Mm-hmm. I've done it before, a shorter period on higher. It's just not as good.
No.
So if you really do have the time,
low
use
and
the
slow.
Low and slow.
Hey, you mentioned that piece of meat is a little more tough.
Yeah, like the bottom round, and also any tough piece of meat, like a brisket or mm-hmm. something like that, they tend to be a little bit cheaper.
Mm. Yeah.
I wouldn't cook them in the oven quickly, but if you're doing it slowly, mm-hmm. then they are the best pieces.
Oh,
to
yeah.
use for
that.
Gonna
break so
it down, tastes really.
And then you actually took it and you shredded
so
it.
So yeah,
right?
just use two forks is the easiest way to do it, and just shred it up nice and so it's
just
got
kinda
like lovely
pull
strand.
It,
there you go. Just pull it apart.
Pull
like
it apart
pork.
Like this.
What else went inside our slow cooker?
So we had the tomato, crushed tomatoes, mm-hmm. some garlic, red onions, some red wine, and the herbs, the oregano, the parsley,
man,
the basil.
It smells yum. So good.
And it just gets so thick
yes.
and lovely.
Do you want to just stick your head in
I
there?
I do. You know what I do? If I could, I would.
It's like bobbing for apples.
It really is. It looks so good and easy. And really, the because it has been going low and slow, it's really just coming apart very, very easy. Really easy.
And we've got some Parmesan polenta here to serve it with. As I was saying to you earlier, you can serve it up with polenta or pasta, or if you want to make it into a really good lasagna or a chili, or even top it with some potatoes and make a traditional cottage pie. It's a base for so many dishes.
Yeah, it smells great. It smells so
How
good.
How did you make this polenta?
So polenta is really, really simple. It's just going to, if you want to put a little bit of water in just to loosen it up. So all you do is you get your water lovely and hot, lovely salted water as you would with pasta.
Right.
And then you pour in your polenta. You want about 2 cups of water for 2 cups of polenta. And then butter, cheese, salt and pepper.
Everything that's good.
Just mix everything that's good, mix it up. And you can either serve it like this, you can see it's lovely and soft. Or if you pop it into like a baking dish, leave it to set, it'll solidify. You can then cut it into slices or cakes and fry it or bake it. And then it gives you just another kind of like crispy texture to
nice.
That polenta.
Very nice.
So
it's so good even on its own.
Absolutely.
Okay, now
morning, like you would for a cream of wheat or something.
So now tell everyone what Holly Likes to Cook is.
So Holly Likes to Cook is my blog. It was started off entirely as a hobby, just to keep me busy while I first moved here and didn't have any friends.
Where are your friends?
Which, if you haven't noticed by her accent, she's not from here.
I don't know around here. But I was very lucky. I was asked to do some writing for some local magazines, and yourselves very kindly asked me to come along here. I'm now actually a private chef as well, so if anybody has any in-home events that they're looking for a chef, or they just want their freezer stocked with simple meals for the winter, then give me a call or get in touch with me through my blog.
And you'll make stuff like this?
Absolutely.
You may be hired quick.
So how do we serve this up?
I would
just polenta down first?
Yeah, big spoonful of polenta, and then using the tongs there, get yourself a nice a bit of beef on there.
Just scoop
here we go.
Over
I'll make a little
mix a little well in there so you can get awesome sauces.
There you go.
And then just kind of grab a hold of this here.
Yeah,
it's like you would mashed potatoes.
Look at this. Look at all this goodness here.
And then you can even get the spoon in there if you want a bit more juices over that.
Here.
Waste
put
that
some
lovely
more
sauce.
Of this in.
Yeah, just mix. It's all getting mixed anyways.
Yep.
Let me get some of that sauce.
Okay.
Teamwork.
There you go. I feel like the messier it is, the better it's going to taste.
Yum.
Holly has a lot of friends now.
Yes, she does. All right, we've got the forks ready. We're going to give this a taste. And if you want this recipe or more information, head on over to roadshow.com.